In this video, we're going to talk about the method of characteristics. The method of characteristics is a technique for solving partial differential equations, and it is a technique which shares sort of a common idea with many other techniques, and that is to reduce the PDE to usually a system of ordinary differential equations, and then hope that you can solve those rather than trying to solve the original PDE. So let's start by defining essentially the position of a moving observer. So let's say x of t is a position coordinate depending on time, and we'll call this a moving observer. You can think of me on my cart from the last video. And let's let u of x comma t just be any old function of x and t. It doesn't need to be a solution to a specific PDE at the moment. Okay, now the question that I am going to ask is, how is u changing from the perspective of the moving observer? So how does u change from the observer's perspective? Okay, now let me draw a couple of pictures just to make this question that I'm asking clear. So let's say here we have the u-axis, and here's the x-axis, and I'm looking at a fixed point in time. Okay, so here's some particular point in time, and I see there's the graph of u versus x, so some fixed point in time. And if I'm looking at this graph from my cart here, and my cart is moving, okay, and it's located at each particular point in time, it's located at x of t. So here I am standing on it. This question is the question, what do I see? How do I see the point right in front of me moving? So if I look right straight in front of me, I see this point on the curve. Now as time passes, my cart may move back and forth, and I'll see another point right in front of me, and the curve may also move up and down, etc. And the question is, how do I see this curve changing? Let me draw it in another slightly different way. Let's say I have now x versus t. So you can imagine what I did is I just sort of added a time dimension right here, like a t dimension. So this is this plot right here, and here's time. I'm going to remove that because it doesn't really fit into that picture there. And let's say that here's my path. Okay, so I start at some point, and I, you know, here I go. And my path is x of t, comma t. And you know that at every point in this plot, everywhere, I have a value of u of xt. And so the question, how does u change from the observer's perspective, says, how does u change when I move along this line? How does u change when I move along this line? Let's answer this question. So the way we're going to do that is by computing the derivative of u, where I plug in for the position coordinate, the position of the moving observer, and then the time coordinate, just as normal. So this, well, let's write this as du dt. I know that's sort of a funny looking thing, but I think of u as being this function of t alone. And this is ux dx dt plus ut. Now that's by the chain rule. Now, what does this tell us? Well, look at this expression right here that we've discovered, this equality. Now, it looks a little bit like the transport equation, for instance. So let's write down the transport equation just to compare it to. So the transport equation was 0 is equal to c times ux plus ut. So if this was 0 and dx dt was c, it would look just like the transport equation. Okay, so let's write that down too. So dx dt is c, and du dt is 0, then that expression looks just like the transport equation. What does it mean for dx dt to be equal to c? Well, it means that the moving observer is moving at a constant speed of c. So moving with speed c. Just like I was in the last video where I was watching the wave and moving along at a constant speed equal to the wave speed. What does du dt equals 0 mean? It means that u is not changing. Notice that this is exactly the situation that I was describing in the previous video. The wave was moving along with a constant speed of c, and I sat on the cart and moved with that same constant speed and watched the wave not change. So what this is saying is that the transport equation is the same as saying that these two ODE are satisfied. In other words, along these lines, x of t, comma t, when the line is given by a constant slope, in this picture of 1 over c, dx dt equals c, the solution to the transport equation is not changing. So if this function is not changing along this line, then it's a solution to the transport equation and vice versa. It's going to seem like we're beating a dead horse at this point, but I'm going to solve the transport equation yet again. And I promise that this is the last time that I'm going to do it. We'll move on to something different in the very next slide. So, transport equation, last time. And I'm going to do it this time using the method of characteristics, the way that I have sort of outlined it before. So, what is it? It's ut plus cux equals 0. And the method of characteristics says that this is the same, so characteristics, says that this is the same as the statement that du dt is equal to 0 along curves given by dx dt is equal to c. And in this case, they're just lines. All right, so this is the technique of solution, to look at the problem like this rather than like this. So first of all, let's figure out what these guys are. This is not so hard, right? This is dx dt equals c. That's just a constant, and that implies then that x is equal to c times t plus x0, where x0 is a constant of integration. Okay, let's draw ourselves a little picture here. So we have the x-axis and the t-axis, and the solution to this, the graph of this guy right here will be a straight line, and it will have slope 1 over c, and it will intersect the x-axis at the point x naught. If you're confused by the 1 over c, think about the fact that these two coordinate axes are flipped. X is a function of t, but the whole thing is flipped. And this is the line x minus ct equals x naught. Now, u is constant along this line. That's what characteristics say. U is constant along this line. So in other words, if I know u at this point, then I know it along this entire line. And similarly, for any of these other lines, if I knew it at this point, right here on the axis, I would know it along the entire line here. So this problem is practically begging for an initial condition. If I know what u is along the x-axis, in other words, at time 0, then I can just use the characteristic lines to propagate the value of the solution throughout all of the space. So let's write that down. We need an initial condition. And that's going to be, say, u of x, comma 0 equals, and let's just say f of x. And this is an initial condition along the x-axis. Okay, so it just says what the value of u is along this entire axis. In other words, for t equals 0. So since we have an initial condition, we know what the value of u is along the x-axis. And if we know what the value is at a particular point, let's say x-naught, then since u is constant along the line, that value will propagate along the line as being the same value. So along this red line, u is equal to f of x-naught. So let's write that down. So along characteristic lines, x minus ct equals x naught, u of xt is equal to f of x naught, which is equal to f of x minus ct, right? Because x naught is equal to x minus ct. Now you notice here that it didn't really depend on which line I picked, because all I would have to say is that u of xt is equal to f of x minus ct, and we know that x minus ct, wherever I plop down in the xt plane, here I am, x minus ct is going to be equal to that point where the line will intersect the x-axis. So really the conclusion is that I don't need to reference that x-naught point at all. All I have to do is say u of xt is equal to f of x minus ct. So let's write down a full conclusion. Then the solution to the initial value problem, ut plus cux equals 0, and u of x 0 equals f of x. The solution is u of xt equals f of x minus ct. And this is via the method of characteristics. And you'll notice that this is exactly the same solution that we derived in the last video, although we didn't talk about initial conditions explicitly in that video because we didn't really have to. And here it was more pertinent to do so. In the time remaining, I'm going to give you an exercise. So I kind of lied when I said I wasn't going to talk about the transport equation anymore, but now you have to talk about it because you have to solve this exercise. So the exercise is to solve the initial value problem. Remember, initial value problem consists of a PDE plus some initial condition. And the PDE in this case is transport equation with a 1 on the right-hand side. So it's non-homogeneous or inhomogeneous, not a 0, but a 1. And then an initial condition which says that at time 0, u is equal to sine of x. So use the method of characteristics to solve this equation. And go ahead and pause the video now, and I'll give you a hint after the pause. All right, hint one. Remember the general equation that describes the way that u changes along the characteristic lines. That's du dt is ux dx dt plus ut. And so to compare it with this guy, I would have essentially the du dt would be a 1, and then ux, and then the dx dt would be a c plus ut. And so my equations for the characteristic lines would be dx dt equals c, and then I'd be left with this du dt is equal to 1 instead of 0. Okay, that's hint 1, so go ahead and pause if you want to continue. All right. Here's hint 2. The fact that du dt is 1 means that along characteristic lines, u changes as t plus some constant. Okay, and this is along characteristic lines. Okay. So at time t equals 0, the t will become a 0, and the a will become simply the initial condition that we have, which is sine of x naught. And remember that sine of x naught is given by x minus ct, wherever I am in the whole xt plane. Pause now if you don't want to see the solution. I'll put the solution up in the upper right-hand corner momentarily. And the solution magically appears.